Okay. Now we'll continue the second lecture with basic definition of unit vector. Okay. So what is exactly a unit vector is? Okay. If you have a vector A bar like this, okay. Unit vector is a smaller vector, okay, which is represented by a cap. And if bigger vector is having a magnitude of mod a, okay, if bigger vector is having magnitude of mod a, smaller vector will have magnitude of 1, okay, a cap will have magnitude of 1, okay. So if there are vectors A bar and a cap, okay, so A cap will indicate a unit vector and A bar will represent a big vector. Now, so magnitude of unit vector is 1. Okay. Now, if you are taking A bar, okay, previously we have written A bar is equal to mod A into A cap is what we have written. Now from this, A cap is A bar by mod A. Okay, A cap is A bar by mod A. Okay, so this is your vector. Okay, and this part is your magnitude. Okay, so this is your basic idea of unit vector. Now, continuing further, okay. So if I have a vector A bar is equal to AX I cap plus AY J cap plus AZ K cap, then, okay, your unit vector A cap will become A bar by mod A, okay, A bar by mod A, which will become AX I cap plus AY J cap plus AZ K cap whole divided by mod A, so which will be AX by mod A into I cap plus AY by mod A into J cap plus AZ by mod A into K cap, which in turn becomes, okay, cos alpha I cap plus cos beta j cap plus cos gamma into k cap. This is your unit vector. Okay. And coming to your difference between, okay, coming to, okay, difference between, coming to difference between a bar and a cap. Okay. So if you are considering a bar this side and a cap this side, for this part your magnitude is mod a, okay, depending upon 2D or 3D you know how to calculate it, but a cap magnitude is 1, okay, and direction is same, magnitudes are different for these two, but direction will be same, direction of a bar is a cap, direction of a cap is also same. Okay, so for a cap direction is same, for a bar and a cap magnitudes are different. Okay, so magnitudes are different for a bar and a cap. Okay, so this is your basic idea of unit vector. Okay, so we have to use this while solving the problems. And remember, I cap is, okay, vector along x-axis, unit vector, okay, unit vector along x-axis, okay, and j cap is vector along, unit vector along y-axis. K cap is unit vector along z axis, and minus k cap, if I am writing along negative z, minus j cap along negative y, and minus I cap is unit vector along negative x axis. Okay, now after this part, okay, we'll discuss something very important, that is, okay, writing, okay, which is called as, okay, this process is called, what we are going to do is called resolution of vectors. Okay, the process that we are doing is called resolution of vectors. Resolution of vectors is nothing but writing vectors, okay, writing vectors in terms of I cap and J cap is what we are going to do. This process is, okay, writing a given vector in terms of I cap and J cap is nothing but what you are calling it as resolution of vectors. Now, resolution of vectors is very important task, okay, because we keep doing this in every chapter, okay, in every chapter in physics that we are going to see later in mechanics, we are going to use resolution of vectors. So, what is meant by resolution of vectors? I'll explain, okay. So, observe carefully, okay. So, now in resolution of vectors, okay, first thing that I want you to understand is an example, okay. So, but before that, I forgot, if you have a right angle triangle like this, this angle is theta, then this part is your hypotenuse, this part is your opposite side, this part is your adjacent side. Now, if you take sine theta is opposite by hypotenuse. That implies your opposite side is hypotenuse times sine theta. Okay, hypotenuse is of course the biggest side. Okay, so your opposite side is hypotenuse into sine theta. And if you are taking cos theta, okay, cos theta is adjacent side by hypotenuse. So from here, your adjacent side is hypotenuse times cos theta. So adjacent side is hypotenuse into cos theta. Your opposite side is hypotenuse into sine theta. Now, keeping these things in mind, okay, we'll continue. Now, observe carefully, okay. So, if you are looking into this figure, okay, if you are looking into this figure, now, if this is a 3-4-5 triangle, okay, if sides are 3 and 4, automatically 3 square plus 4 square is equal to 5 square, okay, that is Pythagoras theorem, okay. So, I hope you know Pythagoras theorem. Now, in this case, this angle will be 37 degrees. This angle will be close to 53 degrees. Now, from this figure, it is very clear that your sine 53 is equal to cos 37, that is equal to 4 by 5. Cos 53 is equal to sine 37, that is equal to 3 by 5. Because in trigonometry, you must have studied sine of 90 minus theta is equal to cos theta. Okay. So, for what I'm going to explain next, you are supposed to remember this. Okay. So, next explain cheyabeyadanikosam idi vankostad anamata. Okay. Now, if you are looking into this figure, okay. So, whenever you see 37 and 53, you should relate it to 4 by 5 and 3 by 5. And next. Okay, another important idea is, if you have a vector represented it as a bar, then this part will be indicating this magnitude. So, length corresponds to magnitude. So, length of this vector is nothing but the magnitude of vector. Okay, so you just keep it in mind. Okay, now using this idea, I'll move ahead. Okay, so I'll discuss a situation. Now, Let us consider a situation like this. Now, let us say a man is going a distance of 5 meters, okay, and he is making an angle of 37 degrees with positive x-axis. Now observe carefully, if this is some point O, this is some point P, okay, one is point O and other is point P. Now let me draw perpendicular onto the axis like this, okay. So let me drop a perpendicular onto the axis like this. Now from here, this angle is 37. So this is your phi cos 37, and this part is your phi sin 37. Okay, because 37 degrees opposite side is phi sin 37. Now similarly, let us consider a case, okay, where in which, okay, let us consider the case where in which you have, this is some point A and this is some point B. Okay, now if you are looking into this figure, okay, to reach P, okay, one way is going from O to A and from A to P. Okay, so I can write, actually my target is OP bar is equal to OA bar plus AP bar. Okay, and this vector is, OA is vector along X and AP is vector parallel to Y. Vector parallel to Y. Now observe this figure carefully, okay. If you are considering this to be B, okay. Now if you consider triangle OAP, okay. Now, okay, observe carefully, traveling, okay, 5 units, 37 degrees with positive x-axis, with positive x-axis is same as traveling, okay, 5 cos 37 is 5 times 4 by 5, which is actually 4. 5 sin 37 is 5 times 3 by 5, which is actually 3, because cos 37 is 4 by 5 and sin 37 is 3 by 5, so that will give you 3. So traveling, okay, traveling, okay, traveling 5 cos 37 units along X plus traveling 5 sin 37 units parallel to Y. Okay, so I cap, I have told you, I cap indicates it is X axis, positive X. J cap indicates it is positive Y axis. So I can write this vector as, if this is some vector A bar, so I can write this vector A bar as 5 cos 37 I cap plus 5 sin 37 J cap. And whatever is before x-axis is called x component. Whatever is before y-axis is called y component. Okay. So A bar ki mundedi x component. B bar y, J cap ki mundedi y component. Okay. So this is how you calculate it. Okay. Now in a similar way, if you look at triangle, okay, OBP. In triangle OBP, okay, this part, if you are considering, this angle is 53. So on y-axis, this part is 5 cos 53 because it is on adjacent side. And your part BP is 5 sin 53 because it is on opposite side. And of course, sin 53 and cos 37 both are equal. Okay. So here, traveling 5 units, okay, OVP is traveling 5 units, okay, 53 degrees with positive Y, okay, with positive Y is, okay, traveling, okay, traveling, you can write this as, okay, just hold on, I think the charge on the pencil has got finished. So just hold on. In the meantime, try to visualize. Okay. So to go from O to P, okay, to go from O to P, one way is going from O to A. That means along X component units along X axis plus Y component units parallel to Y axis. Or you can go from O to B and then followed by B to P. Okay. So that means once again, okay. So here what I want to explain, I'll tell you. So here what you are doing is, okay, traveling, okay, phi sine 53 parallel to X. That means indirectly B to P plus traveling phi cos 53, traveling phi cos 53 along Y. So indirectly you can write phi sin 53 I cap plus phi cos 53 J cap is what you are going to write. That will give you once again 4 I cap plus 3 J cap. Okay, previously how much you are getting? Same thing. This is your X component and this part is your Y component. Okay, so what is that you are doing is, okay, a vector which is in that direction, okay, you are just making it into two parts. One part is along X axis, okay, and other part is along Y axis. Okay, so that is how you calculate the things. Okay, now what is exactly X component and what is exactly Y component, I'll put it. Okay, but remember, because this vector is in first quadrant, you have positive X component and positive Y component. But if I have my vector along other component, that is in second quadrant, then you will have negative X and positive Y. In third quadrant, negative X and negative Y. Fourth quadrant, positive X and negative Y. Okay, so now we'll see, okay, what is meant by the component here. Okay, so if you have a vector like this, let us say this is your vector, okay, this is your A bar. Now when rain falls perpendicular to X axis, the length that doesn't become wet on the X axis is, this length will not become wet when rain is falling perpendicular to X axis. So your X component is, okay, your X component is length that doesn't become wet. Length that doesn't become wet. Become wet when rain falls. When rain falls perpendicular to principal axis. I mean perpendicular to X axis. Okay, so your X component is nothing but length that doesn't become wet when rain falls perpendicular to X axis. Okay, next. Similarly, if you are taking, okay, if you are taking Y component, okay, what is Y component is, if rain is falling perpendicular to Y axis like this, then this part will not become wet. Of course, this is a rectangle. So this part will obviously be X component and this part will obviously be Y component. No doubt about it. Okay. So opposite sides will be equal in rectangle. So your Y component is, okay, Y component is length that doesn't become wet. Okay. Length that doesn't become wet. Length that doesn't become wet. When rain falls perpendicular to Y axis. Okay, perpendicular to Y axis. Okay, so I'll give you in different cases what is what. Okay, so let us start with different cases here. Okay, so first I'll consider case one. Okay, in the first case, let us say you have the vector along x axis, positive x. So now if you have a vector a bar along positive x, when rain is falling along x axis, a length of mod A will not be becoming wet. So your a bar will become mod A I cap plus 0 j cap. Okay, right? Next, coming to case 2. Okay, let us say you have your vector in first quadrant. Let us say your vector is here. Now, if this angle is alpha, this angle is beta. Now, if you look at this figure, so this part is your x component, this part is your y component. This part is your y component and this part is your x component. Now, to give answer, okay, in terms of alpha, if you are calculating, okay, so your vector a bar is x component I cap. So in terms of alpha, your x component is on which side? Anante, your x component is on adjacent side. Okay, x component is on adjacent side. So this part will indicate mod A. So hypotenuse cos alpha is your x component. Cos alpha I cap plus mod A sin alpha j cap. Mod A cos alpha I cap plus mod A sin alpha j cap. That is in terms of alpha. Okay. And because it is in first quadrant, okay, you will have positive x and positive y. In terms of beta, if you are taking, okay, in terms of beta, if you are taking, then your a bar is, okay, your x component is on opposite side of beta. So mod A sin beta, hypotenuse into sin theta will give you opposite side, plus adjacent side is your y component. So mod A into cos beta j cap. Okay, here people tend to mug up that cosine component is x component and sine component is y component, but it is not the case. If the angle with y axis is different, is given, cos becomes sine and sine becomes cos. Okay, so you have to remember it. Okay, next. Now coming to case 3. Okay, you are supposed to remember all these cases are very important. Okay, so you must, looking at the vector itself, you are supposed to answer which vector is what. Okay, next, coming to case 3, if your vector is along y axis, okay, vector along positive y axis, if your vector is along positive y axis, what is that you are supposed to do is, okay, so if this is your vector a bar, now if rain is falling perpendicular to x axis, entire length will become wet. If rain is falling perpendicular to y axis, so you can write a bar is 0 I cap plus mod A j cap. Okay, so a vector along positive y axis will only have y component. Okay, this will have only, this is only your y component, your x component is 0. Okay, next, consider case 4. Let us consider case 4. Okay, now let us say you have vector along, okay, vector along, okay, vector in second quadrant. Okay, so let us consider your vector in second quadrant. So second quadrant, okay, obviously you will have negative x coordinate and positive y coordinate. So let us consider a vector in second quadrant. So if you are considering a vector in second quadrant, so now let us say this is your vector a bar. Let us say this angle is alpha, this angle is beta. Now if you draw perpendiculars onto the axis, this part is your x component, this part is your y component. This part is your x component, this part is your y component. So now your vector a bar is x component is adjacent side, so minus mod a cos alpha, negative because it is in second quadrant, plus your y component is on opposite side, so minus mod a sin alpha j cap. This is your vector in terms of alpha. In terms of alpha, this is your vector. Next, in terms of beta, your vector a bar is given by minus mod a sin beta I cap plus mod a cos beta j cap plus mod a cos beta j cap. Okay, so this is your vector in terms of alpha and beta. Okay, so because it is in second quadrant, I have kept a minus sign. Okay, in second quadrant, x component is negative and y component is positive. Okay, right. Next, coming to case 5. Okay, when the vector is along negative x axis. Okay, when vector is along negative x axis, so that means you have your vector along negative x axis. That means your vector a bar is like this. So in this case, your vector a bar is, if rain is falling perpendicular to x axis, mod a length will not become wet. So because it is along negative x axis, minus mod a I cap plus 0 j cap. Okay, because the vector is along negative x axis, it is minus mod a I cap plus 0 j cap. Okay, next, case 6. When vector is in third quadrant, okay, third quadrant, what is that you have? Negative x and negative y component. So if you are taking a vector in third quadrant like this, okay, so if this is your vector a bar, this angle if it is alpha, this angle if it is beta, okay, so your vector a bar is in terms of alpha, a bar is given by, okay, so this part is your x component, this part is your y component. So in terms of alpha, your a bar is given by minus mod a cos alpha I cap, and your y component is on opposite side, so once again it is minus mod a sin alpha j cap because it is on opposite side. Okay, next, in terms of beta, if I am writing it in terms of beta, if I write, okay, so your vector a bar will become, okay, your x component is this and your y component is this, so this will become minus of mod a sin beta I cap plus minus mod a cos beta j cap. This is how you write the vector in terms of components. Okay, this is case 6 when vector is in third quadrant. Okay, next, now let us consider case 7. Okay, in case 7, let us say your vector is along negative y axis. Now when vector is along negative y axis, so obviously x component is 0. Okay, so if your vector is a bar, then your a bar is 0 I cap minus mod a j cap, 0 I cap minus mod a j cap. Okay, next, case 8. When vector is in fourth quadrant, okay, So fourth quadrant means, okay, you will have positive x and negative y component. So let us say you have the vector in fourth quadrant like this. So this is your vector, and let us say this is a bar. This angle is alpha, this angle is beta. Okay, so your vector a bar in terms of alpha, if you are writing it, okay, so if you look at this figure, this part is obviously the x component, this part is your y component, this part is your x component, this part is your y component. So in terms of alpha, your a bar is plus mod a cos alpha I cap minus mod a sin alpha j cap. Okay, plus mod a cos alpha I cap minus mod a sin alpha j cap. And in terms of beta, if you are doing it or writing it, okay, because it is in fourth quadrant, you have positive x component and negative y component. Okay, so in terms of beta, if you are doing it, in terms of beta, it is a bar is equal to mod a sin beta, because it is on opposite side I cap, minus mod a cos beta j cap. Okay, so this is how you write your vector in terms of I cap and j cap. Okay, so whenever you see a vector, you must be able to write the vector in terms of I cap and j cap, because your triangle law, parallelogram law, all those laws are valid only for two vectors. When you have more than two vectors, you don't have a choice. You have to write the vector in terms of I cap and j cap and then simplify. Okay, that is the best method to simplify. Now, let us consider an example. Okay, so in the following situations, write each vector in terms of I cap and J cap is my question. Okay, so I'll mark the vectors. Okay, so first vector F1 equal to 10 Newton, second vector F2 equal to 20 and the angle here is 30 degrees, third vector F3 equal to 30, it makes another angle of 30 degrees with y. Fourth vector F4 equal to 40. Fifth vector F5 is equal to 50 and it is making an angle of 30, let us say. Sixth vector F6 equal to 60. Seventh vector F7 equal to 70. This angle is of course 30 degrees. Next, let us say this is F8. I am giving it as 80 Newton. And let us say it is 37 degrees here. Next, let us say you have one more vector. F9 is equal to 90. And last, F10 equal to 100 Newton. And it is making an angle of 45 degrees with this positive one. Now, okay, I want you to stop the video and write each vector in terms of I cap and J cap. Okay, then I'll discuss the solution. Okay, pause the clip and then write it and then you verify. Okay, so if you look into the cases, your first vector F1 bar will be 10 I cap plus 0 J cap because it is along x axis only x component. Second vector F2 bar is, okay, 20 cos 30 I cap plus 20 sin 30 J cap. Okay, you have to visualize in your mind. Okay, so there is nothing much fancy. 20 cos 30 is adjacent side, 20 sin 30 is opposite side. Okay, you must know this. Okay, next, third vector F3 bar is, angle with y axis is known. So 20 sin 30 I cap plus 20 cos 30 J cap is your y component. And coming to F4, it is 0 I cap plus 40 J cap. Refer to previous cases that I have explained. And coming to F5, okay, your fi is minus 50 sin 30 I cap plus 50 cos 30 j cap. Okay, next f6, if you are taking f6 is minus 60 cos 30 I cap plus 60 sin 30 j cap, because it is in second quadrant, negative x and positive y. And f7, because it is along negative x axis, it is just simply minus 70 I cap plus 0 j cap. Okay, and f8, if you are taking, okay, it is minus 80 sin 37 I cap minus 80 cos 37 j cap. And if you are taking f9 is, okay, 0 I cap minus 90 j cap. And finally, your f10 is 100 sin 45 I cap minus 100 cos 45 j cap. Okay, so this is how you are supposed to write vector in terms of I cap and j cap just by looking at it. Okay, so choose cheppali anta skill raavali meeku, ala vaste meeku automatic ga subject vastadi. Okay, so idu vaste chalu, maximum sagam calculations problems lo easy aipothayi. Okay, right. So it is very important, resolution of vectors. Okay, keep in mind. Okay, right, that's all.